Mr. Broccoli, you went viral on the internet because you were arrested and you were a piece of broccoli.
Yes.
Do you identify as broccoli? Or?
I am Mr. Broccoli, yes. Yes, that's right, Piers.
Do you have another name or not?
No, Mr. Broccoli is
that's
me.
It.
Yeah.
You don't
it.
Go about your daily business as a piece of broccoli.
I've always been a piece of broccoli.
Really?
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah.
Right. So, do you have a job?
I just grow. Yeah.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, I grow.
He's sprouted up everywhere. Yeah.
And Mr.
You?
Broccoli, what is your aim? What do you want to achieve with all this?
I'd really like to see a transition to a plant-based food system. I think that's vitally important.
Lewis Hamilton, the Formula One racing driver today, well, yesterday, very powerful interview or comments he's given on social media, saying he's reaching the end of his tether about this, friends of his won't listen to him, he feels the world is in serious trouble, and that the only way to save it is that we all go to where you want to go, which is a plant-based thing. So you've got some powerful friends in people like Lewis Hamilton. I mean, how are you going to persuade people like me who want a balanced diet of fruit, veg, meat, like we've always done, and think that that's perfectly OK?
A plant-based diet can be a balanced diet, Piers. It really can. And if you like the taste and texture of meat, there's loads of budding entrepreneurs in the plant-based food market. And,
it doesn't taste the same, though. And there's also increasing evidence that a strict vegan diet, for example, can have bad impact on you.
No, I don't think that's true.
Well, the scientists are saying it.
Well, you know, I think...
Children may end up being more stupid, they say, if you have only a vegan diet, for example.
Piers, I don't know much about, you know, all I know that a plant-based food system.
You don't know much
is...
about the science. I mean, with respect
I'm
to
not
broccoli,
a scientist,
if you're going to tell me
mate.
To give up meat, you've got to know about the science. Otherwise, why should I listen to you?
Well, Piers, a plant-based food
Are you
system
calling
is...
Piers peas?
Well, yeah.
Why?
I thought it'd be quite nice.
Can I just ask a straightforward question? And without any comedy, are you a plant? As in, because your argument dressed up as a broccoli just strikes me as so absurd.
Well...
That you're wearing a costume, but you're trying to get a serious point across about veganism.
It is a serious point,
Are you actually not part of Animal Rebellion and Extinction Rebellion but somebody who's trying to send up the whole movement? Because I'm
not
sure you're
going
to win anybody over dressed as a broccoli trying to make a serious political point about how to stop climate change by changing your diet.
Yeah. I hear what you're saying, and we are in extremely hot water about this. You know, it's going to go pear-shaped. But I think...
What is?
This is a joke, isn't it?
No, it's not a joke. It's not a joke. But I do think that, given the gravity of the situation, some levity and humour is important. You know, we need to be able to deal with this.
Do you practice what you preach? I mean, when it comes to the environment at home, do you have televisions and electrical devices, computers, laptops,
no,
phones?
No, I'm just a broccoli.
He is just a broccoli.
I don't have electric.
You said yourself recently that there needs to be less fury, more common sense.
I agree with
in
that.
The debate.
And it's got him on TV today, so I do agree. I do think all these debates would benefit from a little bit more levity and humour.
You think these debates benefit from people dressing up as a broccoli?
I think it got him noticed and it's got him on television.
But
right?
I'm not sure you're getting across the scientific argument.
Well, that's where I have a slight issue. If you don't know the science about this, how convincing can you be to people?
I'm just a humble broccoli, but I want people to be able to feel like they can come and take part in this protest.
Yeah, but you have to explain to them why you believe a plant-based diet is actually going to be effective. If you don't know the science, how can you do that?
It's quite easy.
Well, hang on, sorry.
Well,
we're talking to Mr. Broccoli.
Well, I am just a broccoli.
Right, but Mr. Broccoli, you have a point to make, don't you, other than just
dressing
up in a costume?
Yes, my point is that environmentally speaking, we're in incredibly hot water and we do need to transition
you
to
don't
a
know why,
food
do you?
System.
You don't know the science. You don't know why you think we're in hot water.
Well, I'm just a broccoli at the end of the day.
I get that.
Yeah.
But what are you doing there?
Sorry, I've just got a call. That's the wrong way up. Hold on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're not really helping the argument,
are you?
I mean...
The trouble is, Mr. Broccoli, when you come on...
That was my friend,
Mr. Broccoli,
sorry.
Had you made a very coherent, powerful, science-based argument
Which
for your
you could have even done if you talked about the amount of methane,
that?
For
had
instance,
you done that? You'd have had real impact. You've had a lot of
animal
attention.
Animal agriculture does produce
No, but you'd have had a lot of attention then for through the way you've dressed up for your cause. But to come on here and just be an idiot makes us think you're just an idiot.
Oh, I do think you need to understand my client is just a broccoli. It's easy to really easy to cherry pick the science. There's science that says it's a good.
All right.
Yeah. Science that says about.
He's not a broccoli, is he? He's a human being dressed as a broccoli.
And when you keep using the fruit and vegetable sort of comedy comments, I just think you're not doing your cause any help at all.
I think it's easy to talk about individual change. But what we're talking about is...
You don't seem to find it easy to talk about any change, actually. And I think for those people who are genuinely... People are genuinely concerned about climate change.
Yes, they
are. And I think you have an extraordinary opportunity right now because of your profile.
Give me one scientific fact why I should give up eating meat.
Plant-based food system is great for the environment.
That's just a load of... And all waffle, isn't it, broccoli?
Well,
that's the problem.
What we need is systemic change to move towards a plant-based food system. Okay. This is about the government, not about us individual, normal working
class
people.
Well, you've sort of made it about you individually.
Who can't afford
You've basically spent 2 weeks paralysing the City of London, and when we give you the chance to come on national television and present your case, you sit there, dressed like a broccoli, saying, yeah, you should eat plants.
But that's because this is absurd. Yeah. The fact that we have to come and justify what scientists are actually... Mainstream science is telling us that's what's absurd, not what we're doing.
Absolutely.
Okay. Absurd. You don't think this is absurd?
Not at all, not in the circumstances at the moment.
No.
And what is absurd is the government inaction on climate change that we have to take to the streets
why,
in the
do
first
you,
place.
Broccoli, that's the problem. You know you want action on climate change, but you don't actually understand why you want that.
No.
Because you're a broccoli.
I am just a broccoli.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's where we're going to leave it. Mr. Broccoli, thank you very much indeed.
16 minutes.
Give Piers a chance.
Yeah. Yeah. We give him a chance.
And come to the veggie party on Saturday.
I won't be at your veggie party on Saturday. I'll be eating a big steak.
You've done more for the vegan cause than anyone
this
year.
Meaty T-bone. Probably a 36-ounce steak. Probably two of them, actually. I might have one of those tomahawks. Yeah, I mean, I'll send you a picture of me gnawing it.
Look,
and
I'm
then
a
when you say, why are you doing that? I'll go, because I'm a tomahawk.
I'm a vegetarian. I'm half on your side, but you haven't managed to convince me. And I think if you can't convince me, and I'm a potential
supporter... You can't convince the most virtue-signalling woman on British television.
You've lost your audience.
You've lost.